study tips that I wish I knew before college. Because college kicks your butt. Go to the library. You can study at cute cafes and all that cute stuff when it's a low pressure situation. But if you have a test tomorrow, I don't want to see you chilling in Starbucks with a caramel macchiato. Take your caffeine and head to a library. It was really the only place that I could focus on campus. Never pull an all-nighter the night before your test. If you're gonna stay up super late studying, give yourself time to sleep before the test, and also make sure you have time to wake up and go over what you studied the night before. You can pull an all-nighter 2 days before, 3 days before, but not the night before. Sleep actually helps you recall everything you studied. You only have 2 or 3 exams per class, usually. Take that ish seriously. And I'm not gonna say, oh, study 2 weeks in advance. You can do that, but I know a lot of us are used to waiting till last minute. If you wanna be in good shape, my genuine advice is to start studying 4 days before your exam. And when you're studying, even if you typed all your notes, write them out. Let me know if I should make a part 2.
Here are 5 essential study tips that you were probably never taught. Number 1, blurting. Rather than just passively rereading your textbook, highlighting your notes, which is amazing and easy and fun, which is why we all do it. You need to use revision techniques which use something called active recall. Active recall is hard. It is taking knowledge out of your brain instead of just rereading stuff. To do some blurting, I'm gonna choose something to remember. Let's do chapter 1 biology. I'm gonna test myself on it. And I'm gonna write down every single thing that I can remember from that chapter from memory, and I can use a few prompt words if I want from the chapter, but I'm just gonna go ahead and write. Here we go. Then you just get a highlighter and you compare it to your notes or your textbook, and straight away you know what you don't know. It's such an efficient use of time. You now know what you need to work on more. I dare you to go try it for something you're trying to learn. My book with all my top study tips is coming out on the 5th of August. Follow for study tip part 2.
Secrets your teachers don't want you to know. Copy any article and search for SpeedWrite. This website has an AI that writes your entire essay without plagiarism.
If you're a student and you have to write an essay, you're going to love this. Go to the Shortly AI website and start writing your essay. Click on the Write For Me button and text is going to be auto-generated 100% plagiarism free.
Secrets your teachers don't want you to know. Search for pre-post SEO. It can rewrite all your paragraphs that you find online. It can check plagiarism and also correct all your grammar.
So to speak, pussy you sour. Never giving credit where it's due, cause you don't like pussy in power. Venom.
If you're a student and in health focusing while working from home, you're going to love this. With LifeAd.io, you can add different virtual study spaces with different visuals and sounds. You can also use the Pomodoro Technique Tracker for studying, and it's free.
The way I did before.
Three easy psychological tricks to study faster, part 1. 1. Study for 20 to 25 minutes and then take short breaks of 1 to 5 minutes and then repeat. This is called the Pomodoro technique. Our brain remembers information better in small bursts. 2. Try to explain the information to another person. This will help you understand the information better because you will concentrate on the important stuff. 3. Go to sleep right after studying. This will help improve your memory for what you've just learned.
A study hack that I know works because I use it, part 11.
Go to your kitchen and grab a glass. Now fill it up with water.
Yummy. Now go back to your desk and put the glass of water right beside it. Tell yourself you're gonna study until that glass of water is finished. And you can't rush this, you have to drink it naturally. I know this sounds silly, but I swear it has helped me.
study tips you needed to know like yesterday.
You used to spend hours drawing detailed diagrams and making detailed notes. That feels really productive, and that's what our teachers always tell us to do, but it is extremely ineffective compared to active recall. Active recall is where instead of taking notes, you just write down questions for yourself to answer later to retrieve that information. I use the app Notion for all of my active recall notes. It's actually better to batch our work and subjects. Teachers always tell us don't finish the assignment on Monday, but it's actually kind of wrong. Studies have shown that when we are constantly switching from different subjects like English to math, it's actually harder for our brain to really get deep into the work.
Here's one of the best ways to study for a test. So first, grab a notebook, take a marker, and write the subject at the top of your paper. Next, grab a pen and a highlighter. Take a pen or a marker and write down the unit that you're learning. Then take your highlighter and make lines for each subtopic that there is in your unit. So let's say in my unit there are three main things I need to learn, so I'm going to make three lines like this. You're going to take your pen and then write topic 1, topic 2, and topic 3, but write down the actual name of the topic. This is just an example. Now, write down every single thing that you remember in bullet points. So just be vague and make a list, not a whole paragraph. Once you're done, you're going to look at the topic that has the least amount of information or the one that you struggle the most on. You're going to make another line halfway in that box that you struggled on, and then write a new set of notes on the side so you can improve on that. Or you can do it on a separate page. Keep doing this until you have a good understanding of the whole unit.
Study Hacks Every Student Needs to Know Part 2. If you have any assignments or research to do, you have to download Mendeley for your referencing. It syncs with Word and has so many different referencing styles for you to choose from. All you have to do is upload your source and it does the rest for you.
Study tips smart kids don't want you to know.
When your teacher's lecturing, don't write down notes.
That is a passive strategy. Instead, use active recall where you just write down questions about the lecture and then later review.
Click the plus button for some more helpful tips.
Scientifically proven study tips. A lot of the time, reading and highlighting in a book is actually not the way to go. Studies have shown that in most cases, it doesn't really help with understanding and it doesn't help you link knowledge and key concepts together. Instead, try this. For every page or even paragraph that you read, write down everything you remember on a piece of paper. This is active recall and it really helps with long-term memorization. Plus, it's a really good indicator for whether or not you're actually paying attention when you're reading. And a little add-on tip, for even better memorization, read through the paragraph or the page one more time and then fill in on the piece of paper what you didn't remember in another color. And as always, happy...
Shh. Yeah. Story.